So now I'm going to turn to my colleague from WHO, Dr. Soumya. She's the chief scientist at WHO. WHO is a close partner of the ITU. We have lots of initiatives that we work on together. As you know, in 2003, when we had the first phase of the summit, world leaders agreed to actually connect all the world's hospitals and all the world's clinics by 2015. We didn't quite get there. And then, of course, in 2015, we had the SDG summit and the adoption of SDG 3. Can you share with us from the WHO perspective how your new digital health strategy can help us to accelerate progress to achieving SDG 3? Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And many thanks for having WHO on the panel. It was realized by many countries all over the world that digital technologies and tools can play a major role in really addressing some of the big challenges we have in healthcare delivery, particularly in lower income settings. Because just to give a few examples, it could help to map the facilities that are available using GIS. You could have real-time data on drug supplies. Vaccine cold chain systems are now monitored using digital technologies which are on the vaccine vials. You can use, obviously, you know, decision support systems on mobile phones to help frontline healthcare workers provide the best possible care, especially where doctors are scarce. And you can use it to reach people directly through messaging. Again, the ITU and WHO have been working together on a Be Healthy, Be Mobile campaign for many years now. And some of the examples in countries show that whether it's diabetes or whether it's quitting tobacco, these mHealth technologies delivered through simple mobile phones can actually be quite effective. So there's a whole range of applications, even without getting into very high-tech things like artificial intelligence-based diagnostics that can be applied. So last year, WHO was asked by several member states to develop a strategy, a global strategy for digital health. And in the next few months, we will be engaging in a number of multi-stakeholder discussions, including at our regional committees, to really define what should go into that strategy. But the broad contours of that are really to be able to first engage stakeholders to define what the key issues are that need to be addressed to catalyze the application of digital health interventions. Because I think it's been mentioned several times today that inclusiveness is very, very important. And unless governments start scaling up this and start using it in the day-to-day business of delivering healthcare, it's unlikely to have major impacts on health. And then also one of the goals would be to measure the impact of this. We already have a website, a digital health atlas. There's also a digital health index, which measures the stage at which countries have reached in their capacities. Another interesting development late last year was that WHO was requested by the governments of Germany, Norway, and Ghana to develop a roadmap for achievement of SDG 3, realizing that the world is off track on the SDG 3 health targets. And so this global action plan for SDG 3, which has now 12 signatories from among the UN family and other multilateral agencies, but this number is growing, has identified 7 accelerators to achieve the SDG 3. And one of them is digital health and data. And so we have a number of a group working together now to really flesh out what this would mean, what this accelerator would actually mean. So we also have the focus group on artificial intelligence for health, and we heard earlier today about the importance of looking at the ethical, social, legal implications of some of these new technologies. So we look forward to working not only with ITU, but with UNESCO and many of the other partners, really, on looking at and also building on the work of the high-level panel that Ambassador Gill just described, the principles that have been described, and that I think it's important to keep in mind the people who are going to be the ultimate beneficiaries. So I think the way we will develop our strategies would keep the people at the center of the development, but then also address the needs of practitioners, and policymakers in this area. Thank you.